The United States Constitution says that all men are created equal, but this statement has not always applied to all the citizens who live in our country. African Americans were first brought to this country as slaves and seen more as property than as humans, and the promise of equality was also not extended to women in the early history of the United States.
Men decided that women's proper place was in the home, and as women wanted more opportunities themselves, and as some women started working and collecting wages, then they understood the difference, the way that they were being treated than men. And at some point, they realized that they needed to solve the issue of what was proper for women to do in society.
In 1848, at the first Women's Rights Convention in Seneca Falls, New York, both women and men discussed this problem and made a decision.
What they hoped to do was start a national dialogue about women's proper place in a democracy. And when it was all said and done, 100 people had signed this document called the Declaration of Sentiments, proclaiming that men and women should all be equal in a democracy. They wanted to make sure that there was a focus and a strategy to changing things. And that's what the convention represents, a beginning of that strategic effort to change society. And it included suffrage, but it included all aspects of legal, social, and political reform for women.
In the antebellum period, the period before the Civil War, blacks and women were fighting for what they called universal suffrage, which means the right to vote for everyone who's an adult. And what happened was that shifted over the course of the period of the Civil War. During the Civil War, the women's rights activists stopped their fight for the vote, and instead they put all their attention into petitioning for a 13th Amendment to end slavery in the entire United States and the territories. In the process, they found that they were being told that they shouldn't speak, that they shouldn't participate in public debates, that they shouldn't participate in petitioning campaigns, and they ended up having to make arguments about their own rights and freedoms.
And make it so that women could do what they felt compelled to do, not what men defined for them. After the Civil War ended, the women's rights movement believed that the way for them to get all women's rights was to focus on suffrage. Through the vote, they would be able to vote in legislators that represented their views, and they would get all the other rights, like equal wages and right to own property and whatnot. And since they had to amend the U.S. Constitution to change and end slavery and to give black men their voting rights and other civil rights, then the women's rights movement believed they needed to start a movement just for voting. So they called it the suffrage movement.